All right, hello everybody. We just did this, so I'm going to do another painting of the lemon, but this time I cut the lemon, so we're gonna do an open version of the lemon. So what do we have? We have a circle, and again I'm gonna put it on the table. I'm gonna make it simple, so I'm gonna do a lemon here. Is just standing, and then I am going to do a lemon that it's standing just like this. It's coming outside and it's behind this little guy here, so you're gonna see a little bit. We have a center. Goes out. We have also a skin, and then I'm gonna see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it cannot be 11, it has to be 12. We're gonna go around one more time and space them out differently to fit them. Okay. So there is my 11 pieces. So the perspective of this lemon that it's standing here, that we're looking at from the top, is different obviously than this. So our slices will be squattier, and this guy's that are farther away, they're so much smaller. This that are sideways, we have a slanted angle right here. And this one on this side. This one also has the skin that we can see, so it's a double line around, and the far side is going to be smaller. Then I'm going to take away as much as I can. So I'm going to leave a very faint version of that. And a lot of times when you're using any paint, starting a little bit lighter and darkening as you go, it's better than going full force with the color. because you want to layer, you want to adjust. More of a orangey yellow. Pushing the water around, and now when this dries, like those little guys, I'm adding a little bit more of an orange right here on the top, where it's gonna make the meaty part of the skin on the inside. We can just push the brush down to create this little effect of the inside of our lemon. So this is still wet, but that already looks much, much better. So again, just like any other painting, you can layer. I'm using a number three brush. Making sure it's not dripping with water. So I'm going to leave this and I will start working on the other part. Just filling in those little pizza slices and leaving tiny, tiny border in between. since there is very little space, I made sure my brush was cleaner, starting with wet in the middle and just going around. So I'm actually trying to push the paint out to leave a little spot in the center. Wiped my brush and I'll take the paint around on the right. Almost a dry brush right now. Gonna use white with the yellow. Create a milky yellow. Still a yellow, but very light. So that's why it's important for me to emphasize a little bit right here at the top. Let's do that before we. Just creating a little patterns with my brush. They pretty much are done by me pushing the brush down and pulling just slightly. And if it's not showing somewhere, I will mix a little bit of yellow and darker orange and just go in here and create a few little shadows. Little tiny pockets. How many times can we paint a lemon? There's no end to this. Because every time you do paint something, you just get better and better. Lemon seems to be like one of my favorite things to paint, I guess, lately. I'm dirtying my paper here. So I'm cleaning my brush. Not rubbing it, but just dabbing it down. Now we can do the same. It's not as white as the paper. I'm just filling in these little areas here. All around each slice. Now the outside of our lemon, gonna go yellow. And I can turn this now the right way. A shadow here, and before it's dry, I just needed a line because that's gonna separate this part and the skin on this one. Just gonna add water here and push the paint around. Turn for the skin around here, just making sure my brush is not gonna drip on me. Just moderate pressure on the brush. Don't have to worry if your hand is not stable because the skin of the lemon is not perfect. So I'm gonna get a little bit of the ochre. Just a hairline of ochre right here. Also, my seeds will get a little bit of the ochre.
Currently in Rancho Santa Margarita, it's 60 and cloudy. Today, it'll be cloudy with a forecasted high of 61 and a low of 49.
Thank you, Google. I need tomato seeds. Still white with the brown. And pretty much I can use my brush and just push down. And that will create kind of a seed. Let's land this lemon. Water, go all around. My area wet so I can drop the color, and it's gonna create this cloud. I'm just gonna push around and control it just a little bit. Add a little more shadow right here. And also, I need water on the top part. And push this down. I wiped my brush, so my brush is not with paint, and gently just swatch this around. I need to push that shadow out. By drying my brush when it's really wet, I can go in and take away some of the water. I'm gonna go back to that pink, so I'm gonna do the same exact thing as the previous painting of the same lemon before it was cut. Now you can always put another thing in your picture, and that maybe the knife or the board that it's sitting on. But I'm simplifying, so whoever is out there that just wants to paint something simple, here it is. And I like to paint things more than once, actually more than a lot of times, because then I get comfortable with whatever I'm painting. You start knowing your subject. Here, and that white just gives me it's kind of interesting, it gives you a little bit of a shine. So I'm gonna go in here and just add a few little spots on the lemon. There's juice pockets. The seeds are not standing out, so I'm going to give them a little more of an outline. And I'm using the shape of the brush in my advantage. Just placing it down and gently pushing. I need to go back to the seeds. I'm just gonna use ochre and make sure my brush is not gonna drip. I just go around and add shadow side. So now it's standing out a little bit better. A few lines if something is kind of losing shape. Oops. Just giving it a little bit of a push. Barely using even the tip of the brush, like it is so much on the tip of the brush that probably it's like a hair or two from the brush that are being used. Making sure there's no water on this part. So just washing it gently and adding a little more of a textured shadow on this part of the skin. Pushing it a little bit further away. Okay, I think I'm gonna leave it here, but this is it. I can actually sign it. And that's it. All right. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, give us thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.